All right, in this section, we will learn how to deploy our project online. So first, here's our sample project to deploy. This website is called Movie House, as you can see. And almost everything we've discussed so far in this course is implemented here. For example, it uses React Router. So when we click the About link, we go to the About page. And when we click the Home link, we return to the Home page. You'll also notice a loading indicator when loading our movie collections for our fictional Movie House website. So when we scroll down, here's the list of our movies. And we have a Load More button here. So when we click this, it will fetch a new data from our remote API and load a new list of movies, which will be added to the current list. Okay, let's scroll down. And when we click on one of the movie cards, for example, this one, a pop-up or overlay will appear, showing the full details of the movie. We can close it by clicking the Close button. And look, here's what our popover or overlay looks like. Okay, let's try again. Load more. And once again, it will load a new list of movies. Let's try Ghostbusters again. Okay, it's working. Then let's go back to the top. All this data is being fetched from the JSON Fakery website. Here's the website. In the movies collection, when we click this, it shows the endpoint we are using in our example website. This is the infinite scrolling pagination endpoint. Okay, we will deploy our example project on Vercel. Vercel is a cloud platform for developers, especially those building web applications. It allows us to easily deploy and manage our projects, with features like global content delivery and automatic security measures, etc. It also allows us to deploy a web application or a website by linking our Git repository and choosing the project you want to deploy. In this section, I will provide you with two examples for deploying our project to the cloud. First, we will use Vercel, and second, we will learn how to deploy our project on our own server. For that, we will use DigitalOcean to spin up a virtual private server with Ubuntu Server as its operating system. We will deploy our project on DigitalOcean and set up our virtual private server from scratch. This means we will install all the necessary software, such as Nginx, Node.js, and others, to run our application on our self-managed server. I will also teach you how to deploy our project and automate the deployment process using GitHub Actions. This way, every time we push to our main branch in our Git repository, our application will automatically deploy whenever we make changes. And by the way, it's true that deploying our project to a self-managed server like DigitalOcean can be considered more advanced. However, since many members of the community, from which I'm a member as well, have been asking about deploying React or Next.js projects on virtual private server aside from Vercel, I feel it's necessary to include this topic in the course. So even though it's not directly related to front-end development in React, I feel obligated to teach it because at some point in your career, you may encounter a situation where you need to deploy a project on a self-managed server or a VPS, such as DigitalOcean or Amazon Web Services. Okay, in the next lesson, we'll start by deploying our example project on Vercel. Okay, so here's the example project that we will be deploying to Vercel. We are not going to create this project from scratch because our goal in this section is to learn how to deploy our production code. However, I will link the example project in our lessons resources so you can download it to your local machine and try it yourself. You can use this example project to deploy to your own Vercel account. Alternatively, if you have other projects you've created, feel free to deploy those to Vercel. But if you don't have any examples, you can use this one, which will be available in the resources section of our lessons for you to download. Okay, let's begin deploying to Vercel. So here is our example website. Let's go to Vercel's website at vercel.com. If you don't have an account yet, you'll need to sign up. Since I already have an account, I will just log in. I'll log in via GitHub. Okay, okay, I'm logged in now, and this is the Vercel dashboard. So now we don't have any projects imported here yet. So we have two options to import a project into Vercel. First is using the CLI or the command line interface or the import project link in the dashboard. Let's start by importing our project using the terminal or the CLI. To do that, we need to install the Vercel CLI, go to the Vercel documentation under platform, then deployments. You can read the article on this page to learn more. And if you scroll down to find the Vercel CLI section, here you will see the command we need to run to deploy to Vercel. First, we need to install the Vercel CLI. Go to the installing Vercel CLI section by clicking this link. You can use npm or yarn depending on your package manager. So copy the command for npm. Now open your terminal, stop your development server if it's running, and then navigate to the root of your project. And then we'll run the command to install the Vercel CLI. So when you run this, you might encounter an error. If you're on macOS or Linux, you may face a permission error. So you'll need elevated privileges to install the Vercel CLI successfully. You can do this by running the command with elevated privileges using sudo. This should resolve any permission issues, okay? Since I have already installed the Vercel CLI on my machine, I don't need to run this command again. Now I'll just restart our development server. Alright, we're done with this step, so we can close this page. Okay, next, we need to push our project to our Git repository. So here on GitHub, I create a new repository for our project and name it Movie House. You can add a description if you like. Here we can set it to private or public. So for now, let's make it public. Then create the repository. Now to push our project to the Git repository, copy this code or command, Go to the terminal and stop the development server. Initialize Git in your project by running git init. Let's add all of these files to our staging area. Then commit them with the initial commit message. Check the status again. Okay. So now we are ready to push this code to our Git repository. Paste the command from GitHub to add the remote origin and the push command to the main branch. If everything is successful, restart the development server. Then, on your GitHub page in the Movie House repository, refresh the page. Okay, great. Now you can see our Movie House codebase pushed to the main branch of our GitHub repository. Okay, it's time to deploy our project to Vercel. Let's go back to our command line. First, stop the development server. Check if the Vercel CLI is installed by typing the command to check the version. If the Vercel CLI is installed, we can push our project to Vercel. Type the command Vercel to start the development process. You'll encounter several prompts guiding you throughout the deployment process. First, it will ask you if you want to set up and deploy the current project. Choose yes. Next, it will ask which scope you want to deploy. Since we only have one project, select the default option. It will then ask you if you want to link an existing project. Say no. And then it will ask for the project name. So just enter Movie House and accept the default project location. Press enter or return to continue. The project will begin uploading to Vercel as you can see. Finally, it will prompt you if you want to modify any settings. Just simply say no, and the deployment to Vercel will start. After the deployment completes, you'll see several links for inspect and production. There's also a longer version of the domain for your project. Visit this link in your browser, and you'll see that our project is now deployed on Vercel. Our page is live and it's protected by SSL provided by Vercel. Okay, everything is working just fine. For example, clicking the About link navigates to the About page, and going back to Home works as expected. The movie list loads properly as well. Let's test by clicking on Bumblebee. Okay, everything is working fine. Scroll down and check if new data loads when we click the Load More button. Okay, it works perfectly. Let's go back to our Vercel dashboard and refresh the page. In the overview section, you will see the project we deployed, which is our movie house example site. Here, you will notice a shorter and more user-friendly version of the URL for our website. When you visit this URL in your browser, you will see that it is the shorter and more readable compared to the longer version we got from the CLI in our terminal. Okay, let's close this page and go back to our Vercel dashboard. Now I will show you how to deploy our website without using the terminal or the CLI. First, let's delete our current project. To delete the project, click on the three-dot menu next to the project name and go to Settings. And by the way, if you click on the menu, you will also see an option for Manage Domains, where you can add custom domains for your website. This is the domain management page where you can add your own domain. Let's go back to Settings. Scroll down to the bottom of the page where you can delete the project. Click the Delete button and follow the confirmation steps. Enter the full project name in the dialog box to confirm the deletion. Then type Delete My Project here as instructed and click Continue. There you go, our project is now deleted. If we refresh the overview page of our dashboard, you will see that the deployed project is no longer there. Also, if you refresh the page where the website was deployed, you will see that the website is no longer accessible. Let's go back to the Vercel dashboard. Here, you'll see the message, you can deploy your first project here. Vercel supports various frameworks, including Next.js, SvelteKit, and Nuxt. So it's not limited to React-based frameworks like Next.js. To import your project from your Git provider, click the Import button. In the drop-down list, you can select your Git account. You can also add a new account or switch to other Git providers, as Vercel supports multiple providers, not just GitHub. Since our GitHub account is already linked, select your Git account. Now you'll see a list of different projects in your Git repository. Find the Movie House project and import it. Select the framework preset, which is Vite in this case, and click the Deploy button. At the bottom of the screen, you'll see the deployment progress. Vercel will show you the steps happening behind the scenes, such as building for production. Once completed, a confetti effect will notify you that the project has been successfully built. You'll also get a preview link and an option to add a custom domain. Click the Continue to Dashboard. Here you'll see the list of production deployments, including the Movie House project with a shorter domain name version. Visit this new domain in your browser, and you'll see that the project is now deployed. Since we deleted the previous deployment, Vercel will assign a new domain name for us. Everything is still working fine. And that's how you deploy a website on Vercel without using the CLI. The advantage of deploying our project to Vercel is that whenever we make changes and push them to our Git repository, Vercel will automatically deploy our project as long as the repository is linked to our Vercel account. To give you an example, let's go to our code editor and open the code base of our project. We'll introduce some changes to a file. So for instance, in our hero section, which is the header of our page, let's modify the title here. So instead of Movie House, we'll change it to The Movie House. So update the title in the homepage to reflect this change. Next, let's commit our changes. Open the terminal and stage the changes. Add a commit message like change the homepage title. And then push the changes to our Git repository. after pushing the changes, go back to the Vercel dashboard. Under the Deployments tab, you'll see that Vercel automatically starts deploying the updated project. You'll notice the status indicating that it's building. Once the build is complete, inspect the deployment. In the preview, you'll see the updated title. Refresh the page to see the changes reflected. If it doesn't show immediately, refresh it again and you'll see the changes we made. This is the advantage of deploying a project on Vercel, because every time we push changes to our Git repository, Vercel automatically deploys those changes for us.